H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Your data adapter will fill the data set. So once your data adapter fills the data set, you assign this data set for the grid view and bind it. Once you execute this binding, you will refreshed grid view you will see in the UI. So these are the steps. So if I repeat the steps, let me go to Windows R, Notepad, first connection, where I will tell the details of the server, and then command, where I will be giving the query to be executed, and then connection command, and then data SQL data adapter. This is used to fill the data from database into dataset. So, and then we'll put dataset, and then I'll fill my DS using adapter, and then for grid view, I will tell that the data source is DS, and for grid view I will bind it. So these are the steps which we need to follow when you want to connect to any database. Okay, so now what is the percentage of understanding, all of you? So first you need to give the details of connection details you need to give, because you don't know which database you want to connect, you don't know which server you have to connect. For that reason you will tell the connection, and then you will give command, what command you have to execute. So either it can be select star from employee, whatever it is, and then you need to fill the data set using data adapter. So, and then you need to give data source. So yeah, how many of you have not understood this? I guess when you practice it you will come to understand. So now we have to see that. So as now we are having select star from employee, but so GV employee details is a grid view. If you go to home.aspx, we have a grid view here. So normally grid view is used to, for example, we have some controls like text box, drop down list, checkbox, we have those values. So those are used for small data controls. But if you want to display a complete table, you cannot use you have to use a control called grid view. Grid view is one of the ASP.NET control. Grid view is ASP.NET control which is used to display values like tables or from the database. Okay, so this is something similar to your text box, but a text box cannot display a table, right? So for that we need to use a grid view. Okay, so this is about how this is a grid view. Okay, so any questions here? Even you can format the grid view. For example, if you see here, when you run this, whatever I see, it's not looking good. See here, let me remove the breakpoint, and if I execute this, this UI is not looking good. It's looking like a plain table. So what you can do here is you can actually go to home.aspx. Okay, and then let me stop this, and then what you can do, you can go to design view. You can go to design view, and then so now I came to the design view, click on this arrow mark. So once you come to the design view, so now what you need to do is click on this arrow mark. Okay, so this arrow, click on this arrow in the design view, and then see I'm just clicking on it, and then select auto format. So click on auto format, and you can select which format you want to display your grid view. So whatever you like, probably select that one. So for me, this is fine. So click on apply and OK. Now if you run this, you can see this is okay. This is a little bit better when compared to before. Or if you're not happy with this, also you can select different options. So auto format, you can select whatever you want. So I can select this one, apply, okay, and you can run this. See, now I'm seeing in different grid view. Okay, so I got a question here. Can I do find any browser? What if we want to give multiple queries?
Can I like do it? Find and browse, like have an employee ID in the form.
Yeah.
When I enter five.
Yeah.
And I hit enter, then I want to see Sanko, Narayan, only that.
Yeah, good question. So now let's try to work on that. Yeah. So now what I want to do it now is, now let me we want to search for an employee. For example, let me go to source view, and what I'll do here is I will add a text box. See, initially it was only one line, ASP colon grid view, but when I changed the format, it auto generated some code here. Some color, back color, all these things, because we formatted this. Okay, so now we will see. I'll tell you what is the question which Ravi is asking. So now what is his question is, in my page what I want to do is I have something called employee ID, and then I have a text box here, and then I have a button like this where I want to search. Okay, so this is what is question. So when I click on search, when I click on employee and click on search, the details of that employee should come in the below. Is that correct, Ravi?
Yeah, that is right.
Okay. So now let's try to work on that. So that is also again the same steps, but before that, the command will change. For this command, we are also passing a where condition. Select star from employee where we need to pass whatever we enter in the text box. So what we need to do now? So we will add here something called employee ID. We'll add here ASP colon text box ID is equal to TXT. ID is equal to TXT employee ID. And then I need to write run it equal to server. Okay, so after this, I'll add a BR tag, and then I have a button, ASP colon button, ID equal to BTN search, and then text is equal to search, and then we need to give run at server. Okay, so I'll add some BR tags here. That's all. So I have a text box now. If I click on designer, see here, I have a text box employee ID and I have a search button. When I click on the search button, I need this. So what I need to do now, double click on this search. So I got this. Now I don't want to display this in the page load. So copy this code, cut this code, and then put this code in your button click. Okay. So but your command will change here. So what is your command? Select star from employee where what is the column name here for employee ID? For select star from employee, so the column name we have for employee ID is EMP ID. So you need to write here, you need to go back and write here where EMP ID is equal to, you need to write here plus txt.txt, like this you have to write. So this is your command. So you told your command now, and now you don't get complete details because you have where condition. So based on this employee ID. So now let's run this and see the difference. So let me run this and see how it looks like. So I'm not writing select star from employee. I have a where condition now. See, now I have employee ID and I'm having, like, for example, I will enter 2 here, click on search. I will only see, did we get any records? Yeah, where employee ID is equal to. So let's see why we are not getting records. Let me put a breakpoint here. So whenever you are not getting the expected result, you have to debug it. So how do you debug? You'll put a breakpoint there and then you will click on the button again. So let me click on this button. So breakpoint is hit now. So let's check what is the command that is getting generated. Press F10 and see here what is the command text. So we can see here, select star from employee where EMP ID equal to 2. So let me execute this. So let me go back to this here and then let me execute this. So why we don't have 2, is it? Let me click on star from employee. Oh, okay, employee ID 2 is not there and we are trying to enter that. So now let me press F5. I think this is working as expected. Let me run this, press F5. And then now I'll enter 3 here, I'll enter 4 here and click on search. So I'm getting that. So only 4 I'm getting. I'm entering 5. I'm getting 5. Shankar. So I'm entering 10. Or say 8. So I'm getting like this. So we might get a question like, if you don't have that employee, we might need to display like employee does not exist. So what you can do here is you add a label below this. Below this grid view, give some space. Okay, you add a label here, ASP colon label run at server ID is equal to LBL message. Okay, so what you can do here is you can inside this your data set will have, for example, here if DS data set is actually combination of tables. So if I have one select query, I'll have one table. If I have two select queries here, I'll have two tables. So as of now, I have only one select query. So dataset dot tables of 0. Okay, tables of 0 will be your first query. So I repeat again, your dataset can have multiple queries. So it can store multiple tables. So as of now, we wrote only one select star from employee where employee equal to 1. If you want multiple tables, you can put a semicolon and you can write multiple tables queries. So what I'm doing here, dataset dot tables of 0 dot rows dot count. If I have this rows dot count equal to 0, so what I can do here, I can put LBL message dot text is equal to employee details not found, and then you can put here an else condition. Else you can actually do this. Okay, I already got this, is it? Okay, yeah. So let me run this and then I'll show you, I'll explain that again to you. Let me stop this and run this. And here what you need to do, in your else condition, you should not show this label LBL message dot visible is equal to false, and here you have to put LBL message dot text LBL message dot visible equal to true. Okay, let me run this. Now I'm searching for an employee here, I'm searching for 3, I get the details of that employee in the grid view. So it's taking time. Okay, I have a breakpoint, is it? So here, okay, so I got an exception saying like no tables are there, but still I'm putting tables of 0. So what I can do here is, I can change this little bit. So I can actually write like this. If ds dot tables dot tables dot count greater than tables dot count greater than 0, and so like this we can write. So I'll explain this again. Let me run this. Ideally we have that employee, right? When I enter five, let me put a breakpoint. Okay, so let me click on 5, click on search, so press F10. So I have this command. What is my command? I have here select start from employee where employee equal to 5. So let me check. I have employee 5 Shankar. I have, so, and then I have this count value is 0. Why the count value is 0? Okay, can you guys guess me why this count value is 0? Anyone? I did a blunder here. So I did one small mistake here. So can you guys guess why is, so this will be always 0. Because I am not filling it. Where I am filling this? I am filling this here. So I should actually put this above. Okay, so let me stop this. And then I have to fill this here. After filling, I can check whether I have the table details or not. So now let me run this. Now it will work like it should work. So let me remove this breakpoint and then go to this place and see. Now if I enter 5, if I enter 6, I'm getting the respective employee IDs. If I enter 6, we don't have 6, is it? Yeah, we don't have 6, but still I'm seeing this grid view. So what you need to do here, when you are displaying this error message, you should put this visible false. So what you need to do here, when you are entering to this, what you need to do here is you need to write, let me modify this code, gv dot visible equal to false, and here you can do like gv dot visible equal to true. Only if values are there, you need to put that visibility equal to true. So let me run this. See, now I'm entering 5. I have this. I'm entering 6. No employee details not found. So I'm entering 10. I'm seeing employee details. I'm entering 20. I don't have employee details. So this is how you need to write the logic. So let me explain this. Okay, so let me explain this and then let me see whether you understood or not. This code is previously written. So now I wrote here, I wrote this additional logic. So to get the value. So additional to this, I have added in the condition select star from employee where employee ID equal to this this condition, because whatever value I enter in the text box, only that employee details I want. So I am writing like this, select star from employee where employee ID equal to this. After that, what I am checking here is, I'm just checking whether if I don't have any records, this count value will be 0. For example, let me put a breakpoint and run this. Let me put here 20 and click on search. So 20 employee ID 20 is not there in the table, is not there in the database. So now press F10, F10. So the moment I fill this, this data set will not have any tables. See, if I click on this, I don't have anything here. I don't have any rows here. So this table count, rows dot count will be 0. See here, because there are no rows. So that is the reason why it is going to if condition, inside this if condition. And it is displaying employee details not found. Press F5. So for example, now it is displaying 0. For example, if I enter now 6 and click on search, see now what happens. Now press F10, 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 F10. Now this count value will be count value? Oh, employee ID. That employee ID is also not there. Press F10. So it It will again fill, show me. Let me press F5. Let me press some record which is there. I think 5 is there in the table. So let me enter 5, click on search. Now if I press F10, F10 is to debug. F10, F10. Now the count value should be 1, because we have one record for that cell, for that command. So when you have one record, what you need to do, you need to go to else condition, and you should not display that message. So that message was there, employee records not found. You should not display that message. So we are making visible false. And then you should display the grid view, because you have one record there. So and then you are binding that and you are showing it. Okay. So now if I enter some invalid record, so already I'm displaying grid view now. Now if I enter here 20, okay, so click on search. Now what I should do now, I should actually press F10, F10. Now 20 count will be 0, because we don't have any rows for employee to 20. So in that case, what I should do, I should not display the grid view now. Already we have grid view for employee 5. Now I should not display that, because I don't have any employees now. So now I should not display grid view, but I should display this message, that employee ID not found. So I am here, I am not dis that's why I am writing grid view dot visible equal to false. When you write visible equal to false, it will not show the grid view. When you write visible equal to true, it will show you the label. So press F5. So this is how you have to write your code. Is it answered your question, Ravi?
Yes, it is awful.
And how much percentage is it clear?
We'll use maybe multiple two, three tables we'll use usually like that.
Yeah, we might use two, three tables, but we will not use in the same command. So for a single command, we'll use only single table query.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so but if you want to use multiple queries, you have to put a semicolon here, and then you have to put tables of one, tables of zero, tables of one. Okay,
Okay.
so let me explain that as well. Imagine I have a table called employee, and I have a table, another table. For example, for that employee, I want to get the details of, say, for example, create table address. Okay, let me check whether we have the address table. We have address table, so let me check. Select star from address. Okay, we have address also. So now what is our goal is, let me add another grid view. So here we'll put here a header tag H1 or H2. Let's not put H1, it'll be bigger. H2. Okay, and then I'll put here employee details. And then I will add another grid view. Say for example, I will have here H2 address. Okay, and then here I will be adding a grid view. So ASP colon grid view ID is equal to GV address, and then I will give run at server. Okay, let's not let this be simple grid view. We'll not format this. So, but if you want, you can format. You can go to design view. So I have two grid views. One is employee details and the address details. So what I need to do now, go to this, and here I need another command. So what I can do here, don't get confused here. I'm going to add another query here. So plus, I'm going to put a semicolon. After that, after semicolon, I'm going to write select star from employee, no, address, where emp id is equal to, I'm going to put here plus txt employee id dot text. So we have two things: select star from employee where employee equal to this, semicolon, select star from address where employee. So we have two tables now. So first thing, yeah. So, just a second. I lost power in my home. Just a second. Okay, so now I have added one more query here. Select star from address where employee ID equal to this. Now, what I need to do now, if tables dot records are there, so first thing I'm binding employee details not found. In the else condition,